We continue now at the top of Daf Mem Beis Amud Aleph from Maseches Yuma. This is Yuma Daf 42a. The Gemara is discussing the weights of the various threads. So the Gemara says Shel Para, and when it comes to the thread that's used by the Para Aduma, Mishkal Asara Zuz, that's the one that needs to be 10 Zuz. Vishel Seir HaMishtaleach, when it comes to the thread that's tied to the goat that is sent out on Yom Kippur La'azazel, Mishkal Shnei Sloim, that's the one that's 2 Sloim. Vishel Mitzora, when it comes to the thread by Mitzora, Mishkal Shekel, that's the one that needs to weigh a Shekel, Rashi over here explains. Shel Para Mishkal Eser Zuz, Deboi Kovet, that one needs to be heavy, so that's going to be the largest one. Shel Seir, Deboi Chaluka, when it comes to the Seir HaMishtaleach, it needs to be enough to be able to be cut in half. Mishkal Shnei Sloim Vidaya Bekach. It's enough if it's just 2 Sloim. That's the medium sized one. And Shel Mitzora, when it comes to the thread that's used by Mitzora, Deloha Veloha, it doesn't need to be heavy. Again, Par Aduma, the thread needs to go Toch Sreifas HaPara, needs to go into the fire. It also doesn't need to be cut. It doesn't need to be divided. So Sagi Le B'Shekel, so it's going to be enough. If it's just the weight of a shekel, again, that's the thread that's used by the Mitzora. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav Yochanan says, Pligi bar Rav Shimon ben Chalafta v'Rabbanon b'Para. There's a machlokus between Rav Shimon ben Chalafta and the Rabbanon when it comes to the thread that's used by the Para Aduma. Chadamar Mishkal Asara, one says it has to be a weight of 10 Zuz. That was the highest weight we gave before. The Chadamar Mishkal Shekel, the other one says it only needs to weigh a shekel. That was the lowest weight we gave before. The Simonech, a way to remember this, that nobody gives the medium weight, which was 2 Sloim. It's either the most or the least. That comes from the following phrase, Echor Hamarba V'Echor Hamamit. Famous phrase is, no matter how much you do, whether it's a lot, whether it's a little, Uvilvad Sheyechavin Libo L'Shamayim, as long as you have the right intention. So the same thing over here, one person gave the maximum amount, and one person gave the minimum. The Gemara says, Amar Le Rabbi Yirmiya Midifti L'Ravina. So Rabbi Yirmiya from Difti said to Ravina, Lo Bepara Pligi, this machlokus that you just cited, it was not by the thread, by the Para Aduma. Ela B'Sir HaMishtaleach Pligi, the machlokus actually was by the thread, by the Seir HaMishtaleach. Is it 10 Zuz or is it 1 Shekel? Same machlokus, but it was by a different thread. Vahu Yoma, and that day, Noch Navshe de Rav Yabar Kisi. On that day, when they had this machlokus, Rav Yabar Kisi died. V'Anchu Bo Simon, and they had the following simon, the way to remember it. Rav Yabar Kisi Mechaper Kisir HaMishtaleach. The death of Rav Yabar Kisi is a mechaper, like we say. The death of Tzadikim is mechaperis. So that's a mechaper, just like the Seir HaMishtaleach is a mechaper. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rabbi Yitzchok. Rabbi Yitzchok says, Shtei Shchitos Shamati. I heard halachas by 2 Shchitos. Achas Shel Para V'Achas Shel Para. One by the Shchita of the Para Aduma, and the other one by Paro, which refers to the power of the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur. Achas Kasheira Bizar. One of them, the Shchita, is kosher by a Zar, by a non-Kohen. V'Achas Psula Bizar. One of them is possible by a non-Kohen. V'lo yadana hayminayo. I don't know which one is which. And the Gemara continues, Itmar, we have a machlokes amoraim on the issue. Shchita as parav uparo. Let's say you have the shchita of the Parah Aduma, and the shchita, when it comes to the shchita again, of the power of the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur, Rav u'Shmuel, it's a machlokes amoraim between Rav and Shmuel. Chad omar parav psula parav ksheira. One opinion says that when it comes to Parah Aduma, cannot be done by a zar, the shchita, and when it comes to the power of the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur, that could be done by a zar. The Chad omar, the other one says the exact opposite. Paro psula, when it comes to the power of the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur, it's possible if it's shechted by a zar. Paro ksheira, when it comes to Parah Aduma, that is okay if it is shechted by a zar. So the Gemara says, Testayim, the Rav Hudamar, Parah Psula. Let us conclude that Rav is the one who says, by Parah Aduma it's Psula, meaning by Parah Aduma it cannot be shechted by a Zar. Diyomar Rabbi Zeira, because Rabbi Zeira said, Shchitas Parah Bizar Psula. Rabbi Zeira said, if you do the Shchita of the Parah Aduma with a non-Kohen, it's Pasul. Viyomar Rav Allah, and Rav said, on that statement of Rabbi Zeira, Elozar V'chuka Shaninu Ba, because it says the word Elozar, and because it says Chuka, that shows it's Ma'akiv, it has to be done with a Kohen. Rashi says, Elozar Ksivbe, you're going to give it over to Elazar HaKohen, again talking about the Parah Aduma. It also calls it Chukas HaTorah. Anytime it says the word Chuka, that's considered that it's Ma'akev, it's something that's a requirement. So therefore, you learn out from the fact that it says Elazar, which references the fact it has to be done by a Kohen, and the fact that it says Chuka, that shows it must be done by a Kohen, it cannot be done by a Zar. So the Gemara says v'Rav, but according to Rav, Maishna Parah, Tichsiv Elazar v'Chuka, Paro Nami, Haksiv Aaron v'Chuka. What's the difference? By Parah Aduma it says Elazar and Chuka. By Aaron also it says Aaron v'Chuka. Rashi says Tichsiv V'Hikriv Aaron as Parachatos Asher Lo V'Chiper. It says Aaron brings it. V'Shachar as Parachatos Asher Lo Ishechs it. Uchsiv Ba'Acharim Mos Binyana V'Hoisa Zos Lachem L'Chukas Olam L'Chaper Al Bnei Yisrael. It says it's Chukas Olam. So we should make the exact same drasha when it comes to the power of the Kohen Gadol on Yom Kippur. So the Gemara says, Shchita lav avoda, Shchita is not an avoda, and as Rashi says, Volo kaima chuka ashchita. The word chuka doesn't go on the shchita because it's not an avoda. So therefore, it's not ma'akev that it has to be done by the Kohen, it can even be done by a Zar. So the Gemara says, Yachi, if so, paranami. Why don't we make the exact same argument by paraduma? That's also not an avoda. So the Gemara says, Shani para dekotche berekabayasi. Paraduma is different. It's true. Maybe it's not an avoda, but it's a whole different kind of kotchim. It's not a kotche mizbeach. It's not a carbon that's brought on the mizbeach. It's berekabayas. It's something that's just part of the Beis HaMikdash. As Rashi says, Kilomra ain't but kedushas hamizbeach. There's no kedushas hamizbeach by paraduma. El kedushas daman bialma. It just has a certain hektish value. Sharei shchitasu b'hara mishchitz. On the Haramishcha, Hilkach ein sar avodos nechlokos ba. Therefore, you don't divide up. This is an avoda. This is not an avoda. V'chol avodos shavos ba. Everything is equal, and so therefore, the word chuka by paraduma is going to go on everything. It's going to go on the shchita as well. The Gemara says v'lav kol tekenu, but according to that logic, it should be a kol shekein because kotche mizbeach is stricter than kotche berek habayis. So if there's a requirement that we say by kotche berek habayis, meaning in this case by paraduma, the shchita should be by a kohen. Certainly, shouldn't that be true by the power that's brought by the kohen gadol on Yom Kippur? And so the Gemara answers, Amar Rav Shisha Brei de Ravidi. Rav Shisha Brei de Ravidi says, Midi dehavi amaros negoyim. No, we have a comparison here to maros negoyim. When a person gets tzaras, they're supposed to show the negat tzaras to a kohen. The lav avodahi, that also is not an avoda. Uboy kuna, there's a requirement of kuna. In other words, you see there are situations of things that are not avodas that in fact they do require the kohen. And therefore we can make that distinction and we could say when it comes to kotche berek habayis, so in such a situation by paraduma, it requires a kohen, but we're not necessarily going to say the same thing when it comes to kotche mizbeach, like the power of the kohen gadol on Yom Kippur. And so the Gemara continues, v'lishmuel da'amar paro psula. Now let's go to Shmuel's opinion. We're now saying that according to Shmuel, the power of the kohen gadol on Yom Kippur, it's psula if it's shechted by a zar. So maishna paro dechsev aron v'chuka. So why does he make a distinction? Why by the power of the kohen gadol on Yom Kippur, it says aron v'chuka, and we mean to say that it can't be done by a zar the shechita? Paranami oksiv elazar v'chuka. Let's say the same thing by paraduma. It says elazar and chuka, and we should say it cannot be shechted by a non kohen. So the Gemara says shani hosam. It's different over there. Tichsiv, because the pasuk says. V'shachat osa lifanov, he shechts it in front of him, which explicitly means to say she'ezar shochet ve'elazar roe, that a non-kohen will shech the paraduma, and elazar the kohen is going to watch. Rashi says v'shachat osa lifanov minichsiv lifanov. It says in front of him mechlal da ashchita lav elazar koi. That sounds like the shchita is not being done by elazar. Ela v'shachat osa acher lifnei elazar. Sounds like on the contrary, somebody else is shechting it in front of elazar, and so therefore that is exactly the proof by paraduma. That's why by paraduma, again, it doesn't need to be shechted by the Kohen himself. So the Gemara says, V'rav, so what does Rav do with this pasuk? V'shachet osa lefanav. Doesn't it sound like on the contrary? Doesn't it sound like by paraduma doesn't need to be shechted by the Kohen? Rav says, Shelo yasiach daito mimena. No, the pasuk is teaching you lefanav, that you cannot have a hesach hadas. You can never take your mind, get distracted from this practice by the paraduma. Rashi says, V'rav li'olam elazar shachta. Really, elazar is doing the shechita by the paraduma. Umay lefanav, Shelo yasiach daito mishmirasa. Lefanav simply means that he can't have a hesach hadas. He has to always pay attention to what he's doing with the Parah Aduma. The Gemara says, Shmuel shelo yasiach daito minole. Now, according to Shmuel, where does he know that you can't have a hesach hadas by the Parah Aduma? Nafkalei, he learns it out, mivasaref, esapar le'enav, a similar kind of pasuk. By the burning of the Parah Aduma, it says you burn it le'enav, right in front of his eyes. Again, you're not allowed to have a hesach hadas. The Gemara says, V'rav, and what about Rav? Isn't this a good source for Hesach Hadas? Chad b'shchita v'chad b'sreifu tzricha. No, you need a pasuk by the shechting of the paraduma, and you need a pasuk by the burning of the paraduma. You need two psukim about Hesach Hadas. Because of Rachmana b'shchita, because if it only said by shchita, mishum d'tchilas avodahi, because that's the beginning of the avoda by the paraduma. Avol sreifa, but when it comes to the burning of the paraduma, eim alo, I would say you don't need to have Hesach Hadas would not be a problem. So tzricha, so that's why it's needed. Because of Rachmana b'sreifa, the pasuk only said it by sreifa that over there hesach hadas is a problem. Mishum dehashtu demiskash repara. It's at the sreifa where really it's becoming kosher to use. Rashi over here explains dehashtu demiskash repara sharei kol atzma in asuya el afer. The whole point of paraduma is to make the ashes of the paraduma because that's going to be used in the purification process. So I would say okay, when it comes to the sreifa, of course you can't have hesach hadas. Avol shchita imalo, but maybe I would think by the shchita that's not a problem to have a hesach hadas. Tzricha, that's why you need the pasuk by both. So again, that's what Rav's going to say. The two psukim are both about Hesach Hadas. So the Gemara says, "Lemuute mai." What does this come to exclude? In other words, when it comes to Par Adum, you cannot have Hesach Hadas by the Shechita. You can't have Hesach Hadas by the Shreifa. Where can you have a Hesach Hadas? Gemara says, "Ilema lemuute asifas afra umiloi mayim lekiddush." Maybe you'll say it comes to exclude the gathering of the ashes and the filling up of the water for the sanctification. Rashi over here says, Asifa Sapora v'asaf ishtar. It says in the pasuk that it has to be gathered up by someone who's pure. Umiloi mayim lasez lesoch efer lahazos. You also take water and you put it into the ashes in order to sprinkle it. Lekiddush, shinasinas mayim alo efer. That refers to putting the water on the efer. Umearvan yachad, you mix it together. So if you're going to say it's to exclude that, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Mem Beis Amud Beis.